sex ring of molesting. Boy, they even had one down here in Texas where they were actually judges, sheriffs, and a whole lot of other people who were involved in the penal system were coming into the I just call them the boys' homes, the correctional centers, at night and partying with the young boys on the weekends, molesting them right there in the facilities. They got caught, and it didn't even get the news there.
Because you had so many people behind it.
So, Richard, with this information, you have, I want to ask you a question. So, do you think that Paterno is the scapegoat? And also, do you think that the heat that he is getting is warranted?
Yeah, well, you know what? I have no doubt. I hate to say this because I know Paterno meant a lot to a lot of people. But let's say if it's no bigger than what you guys have said it is. He should have it. Let's say that was your son. I hate to go there. But if somebody is witnessing somebody's child being molested and it goes to the next level, then the next level, then the next level, every level is supposed to make sure that it gets handled. If it doesn't get handled by his superior, he's supposed to take it to the next superior and the next superior. I was in the military. They say shit rolls downhill. But when you're talking about molesting children, first of all, if you witness it, you're supposed to get extremely violent and then report it because you're going to have to, you know, be filling out police reports because you assaulted somebody. But then beyond that, see, this thing is decades old. That's what I'm trying to, I don't want this part to be missed. Paterno knew about it. Everybody big in that state knew about it. This thing was an ongoing scandal that's immeasurable. It went all the way to Boston.
I believe you. I believe you when you say it, because when I played basketball, and this is serious, coaches that coached me, I hear about them and the stuff they going through as they got those type of charges for fucking with boys. When I went to Triton College, the coach we had was a powerful man in Chicago. His name was Lolino, Frank Lolino. He's passed, but I'm saying his son got in trouble for that whole molesting boys thing. And my other coach for the summer league, he was fucking boys. Now, I believe the reason we didn't get approached, because we were too big at the time. I know when I met them, I was in college. So ain't nobody going to fuck me. But what I'm just trying to say, we'll tear that motherfucker up. It ain't perfect. But what I'm trying to say is, it's common for people who want to fuck boys to come as a coach, come as a mentor of some sort.
The Boy Scouts.
Right. I get that. Yeah. I get that. But what I'm saying is, I'm not necessarily taking up for Paterno all the way. But I watch the news, and I don't like that shit, how all of a sudden this man is the reason this shit happened.
No, or I hear what you're saying, Corey, that he's the only person that's being mentioned in it. Like, it's almost like he did it. Right. I hear what you're saying. I hear what you're saying, though, Corey.
He went to the people that were supposed to be his boss. You can say whatever you want to say about...
Why didn't you... How could you actually... And then continue to work with the man.
This is an important point.
You continue to show up at work with this same man, knowing that you might have told somebody, but then now what? So years pass, and you're okay with this guy?
This is the important point.
That's
the witness who was a coach on the team, who saw it.
Yeah, that kid, the redhead dude. He
spoke up.
All of
it. And I'm going to tell you why he spoke up. Because when you see it, it's a lot different than hearing about it. When you see it, you get fired up.
But
I would imagine.
But he went and told them. That same guy told them.
And look at what happened to him.
Right.
Do you know what he's going through right now?
Yeah. But see,
he's fucking blackballed out the game.
But like he said, this is the dude that just called up and enlightened us on all that stuff. It is bigger than that. I hear you. And I hear what you're saying, that it seems like they're using him as a scapegoat.
All that fucking Paterno bullshit is to close the door on it and act like it's over.
Somewhat.
Now they're going to just go reset it up and tell him to be a little more discreet with the boys to get imported to get fucked.
I wouldn't doubt that.
Because the motherfucking men who really into that type of shit is the motherfuckers that run the motherfucking city or state, wherever they live. All them motherfuckers, it's all that shit. Everybody on top is suspect in my eyes.
No,
in entertainment.
Because they have power.
Right.
And people are afraid. Anybody...
They can fuck who they want to fuck.
Right.
When you see it on the news, this is the point I'm trying to make. The person who gets the bad rap on the news, that's the victim.
Well,
he caught the bad end of the shit.
He did.
He's a small fish.
Well, it's like Richard asked hypothetically a few minutes ago. What if you knew what was going on and how would you respond? Man, fuck the chain of command, man. If I'm the coach and as powerful as Joe Paterno was to the day that he left Penn State, he ain't got to check with nobody. And on a moral level and on a personal level, you got to own up to the mistake you done made by having this son of a bitch up under you. And then when you find out that he fucking these kids, he got to go right now one way or the other.
Who say all them wasn't fucking the kids?
I can't say it's
way bigger than that. Yeah. It was probably me and more powerful than Sandusky probably hung with a lot of power players. Well, they probably like, look, motherfucker, don't be pulling the plug on what the fuck we doing.
That's why it never went anywhere. It was obvious that.
I'm just saying,
obvious.
The man went and told the people he was supposed to tell.
And nothing
happened.
So what does that tell you? It's scary.
If I'm at a job and I go tell my supervisor, hey, I just saw those dudes stealing. Later on, they're going to be like, oh, you've been stealing. So they've been stealing. And you knew. You did it too. They take it too far with this. Put it on the person who wasn't doing this shit. That's what I'm saying.
Okay, I still go back to putting it in a separate category, man. This is children.
Yeah,
man.
Well, let's take.
And that's why we're going to win. Some people ain't taking this shit. They don't care how big the new world, old world order is. You got some real people who, yeah, we might look at them as showmen, but they thinking this shit through. Darlene, Corey Holcomb, and Bobby Blantone is doing a great job. He ought to be speaking out. Where is he at? Oh, I forgot. He's been censored. Getting out, boss.